ग्रुप 15 का नेक्स्ट एलिमेंट अब हम करते हैं दैट इज फास्फोरस. नाइट्रोजन हमने पूरा का पूरा डिस्कस कर लिया, ऑक्साइड्स कर लिए, ऑक्सासिड्स कर लिया, नाइट्रोजन कर लिया. सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एवरीथिंग अबाउट नाइट्रोजन. आज हम लोग नेक्स्ट टॉपिक शुरू करेंगे व्हिच इज फास्फोरस. नाउ फास्फोरस जो था दैट वाज आइसोलेटेड बाय ब्रैंड. ब्रैंड वाज द साइंटिस्ट नेम. और जो शील था उसने उसको आइसोलेट किया था from bone ash. So first time phosphorus that was isolated from bone ash. And also phosphorus ka jo naam hai that was given by Lebesgue. Right, so these three scientists, they contributed towards it. Now phosphorus has a very peculiar property that it glows in the dark. Glows in the dark. When we talking of phosphorus, it is not found free in nature, but mostly it is going to be found in combined state. Jaise for example, it exists as phosphates in all rocks. ठीक है? And it is going to exist as phosphoproteins. It is going to exist as phosphoproteins in all living things. Apart from this, phosphorus, it also exists in all of the following. It is found in DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. It is found in RNA, it is found in adenosine triphosphate, ATP. Then it is an essential constituent of bones, teeth, blood, and also the nervous tissue. Right? Now, what are the principal minerals of phosphorus? जिसमें से हमारे को phosphorus मिलता है? Let's see. We have phosphorite. Which has the formula. Basically, it is calcium phosphate. Which is known as phosphorite. CH3PO4 whole twice. And we have fluoropatite. Fluoropatite, which has the formula it is a double salt of calcium chloride and calcium phosphate. So these are the two minerals jispe phosphorus present rehta hai. When we talking of phosphorus, phosphorus that consists of two isotopes, allotropes. One is white phosphorus and the other one that is red phosphorus. Okay? So let's go on to the first allotrope, which is white phosphorus. When we're looking at white phosphorus, we say that it is a molecular transparent waxy solid. It exists in tetrahedral structure. So it is a molecular transparent waxy solid. Okay? And then number two, in the pure state it is white. Jab pure state mein hum log dekhte hain, it is seen that in the pure state it is white in color, but it appears to us as yellow. That is because of a you can say covering of it. Yellow, it appears yellow on standing. If we've kept it for a longer period on standing, because of a film of red phosphorus which appears on the surface of white phosphorus. ठीक है? तो pure state में white होता है, पर अगर वो पड़ा रहेगा तो वो yellow हो जाएगा, क्योंकि red phosphorus एक उसके ऊपर film बना देता है. Now it is very soft. Therefore, it can be easily cut. With a knife. It can be easily cut with a knife. It has a garlic smell. It is going to have a garlic smell and is poisonous in nature. Right? So, isko hum log bolte hai ki iski wajah se ek disease hoti hai jo ki phosphorus ke saath kaam karta rehta hai bahut zyada. To usko ek disease ho jati hai, which is known as Fossy jaw. Fossy jaw, that is because of the people who are working in phosphorus, they get this kind of a disease. Jahan pe this fossy jaw means that they are going to have a kind of yellow kind of teeth which develop. So this is the disease jo ki phosphorus mein kaam kar rahe log unko ho jati hai. Theek hai? Then next we have is, it is soluble in CS2. Next property of white phosphorus is that it is insoluble in water, but it is soluble in carbon disulfide. CS2 mein soluble rehta hai. Then it, as I just said, that it glows in the dark, and this process that is known as phosphorescence. Phosphorescence, ठीक है? Its ignition temperature is very low. It's going to have a low ignition temperature and it catches fire when it reacts with oxygen. It catches fire due to formation of phosphorus pentoxide, which is P4O10, right? Then, if you're looking at the chemical reactivity of white phosphorus is the most reactive form of phosphorus. It is going to be the most reactive form of phosphorus. It undergoes disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation reaction, more reactions hoti hai, in which one reactant undergoes both oxidation and reduction. So alkalis ke saath jab hum isko react karte hai, it is going to give us NH2PO2+PH3. Over here, if you're looking at the oxidation state of phosphorus, it is 0. और यहाँ पे जब हम oxidation state इसकी calculate करते हैं, this is 2 to the 4, 4 minus 3, that becomes equal to +1. ठीक है? और यहाँ पे जब हम oxidation state देखते हैं, that is -3. So phosphorus is undergoing both oxidation and reduction over here. That is the reason why it is going to behave as, or it is undergoing disproportionation reaction. ठीक है? Disproportionation reaction में एक ही element जो है वो oxidation भी undergo करेगा और reduction भी undergo करेगा. Then it reacts with halogens to form respective halides of phosphorus. Like if we are reacting phosphorus, it forms two types of halides with chlorine or with any halogen. It can give us trichloride in the form of PCl3, or it can give us pentachloride in the form of PCl5, right? और फिर ये metals के साथ react करता है to form respective phosphides. So it is going to react with the metals. जैसे for example, it reacts with magnesium to give us Mg3P2. This is magnesium phosphide, right? So you can balance the reaction over here. Magnesium phosphide similarly calcium ke saath react karega to give us calcium phosphide. Theek hai? So this is what white phosphorus is. Then we go on to the structure of white phosphorus. When we looking at the structure, it has a tetrahedral structure. In which each phosphorus that is bonded to three other phosphorus, right? It has a tetrahedral structure. Yeah, isko aap is tarah se bhi dekh sakte ho. This is how also it can be written. But mostly jo books mein aapko structure iska de rakha hai, that is this structure, right? It has a tetrahedral structure with a bond angle of 60 degrees. The bond angle that is going to be equal to 60 degrees and the PP bond length that is 2.21 angstrom. So this is all about white phosphorus. Let's go on to the second allotrope, which is red phosphorus. The second allotrope of phosphorus that is known as red phosphorus. Red phosphorus is prepared by reacting yellow phosphorus, right? The yellow phosphorus that is heated at 240 degrees centigrade to 250 degrees centigrade in an inert atmosphere to give us red phosphorus, okay? Now when we are looking at the properties of red phosphorus, it exists in the form of dark powder, then it is colorless, and non-poisonous in nature. Odorless. Color to uska dark powder aa gaya na. So it is going to be odorless and non-poisonous in nature. Jo white phosphorus hota hai, that is poisonous in nature, we just saw. Okay. Now it is insoluble in both water and carbon disulfide. It is insoluble in both water and carbon disulfide. It does not glow in the dark. It does not glow in dark. Then its ignition temperature is very high. As we just studied ki white phosphorus ka ignition temperature low hota hai, iska jo ignition temperature hai, that is high. Theek hai? फिर उसके बाद केमिकली इट इज नॉट वेरी एक्टिव. सो इट इज यू कैन से द रिएक्शंस व्हिच इट अंडरगोस दे आर गोइंग टू बी वेरी स्लो. और यू कैन जस्ट सिंपली राइट कि केमिकली इट इज नॉन रिएक्टिव. Chemically, it is going to be non-reactive. Then it changes into white phosphorus. Red phosphorus can change into white phosphorus when it is vaporized. So, जब हम इसको heat करते हैं, तो जो vapors बनेंगे, वो white phosphorus के बनते हैं, और इसको white phosphorus को फिर हम condense करके, we can convert it into the liquid state. When we looking at the structure of red phosphorus, iska jo structure hai, that is a polymeric structure. So we have this is how the structure of red phosphorus looks like. So you can see that it is forming linear chains over here. This also owes to the reactivity of red phosphorus. क्योंकि जो हमने white phosphorus बोला उसका एक monomeric structure है which has only P4 units. यहाँ पे जो units हैं they are going to be present in the form of a chain that makes it a little non-reactive with respect to white phosphorus. ठीक है? Uses कहाँ कहाँ होते हैं? Number one, it is used in the matchstick industry. It is used in the matchstick industry. Then red phosphorus को हम लोग use करते हैं rather than white phosphorus. Okay? So if you have कि matchstick industry में कौन सा use हो रहा है, so in the matchstick industry we generally are using red phosphorus instead of white phosphorus. Yellow phosphorus that is used as a rat poison because of its poisonous nature. Yellow phosphorus that is going to be used as a rat poison. Then P32 that is a radioactive phosphorus. P32, a radioactive phosphorus that is used in the treatment of leukemia, blood cancer में जो chemotherapy दी जाती है, that is P32 isotope of phosphorus. And then number 4, it is used in smoke screens. Is used in smoke screens. Then let's go on to the next compound of phosphorus, which is phosphine. Our next thing is phosphine. Phosphine has the formula PH3. It is known as hydrogen phosphide, hydrogen phosphide, or it is also known as phosphorated hydrogen. Phosphorated hydrogen. ये hydrogen पूरा लिखना है H2O. ठीक है? Now when we talking of phosphorus, phosphorus can be prepared in the laboratory by the disproportionation reaction of phosphorus, which we just did. So phosphorus with sodium hydroxide in presence of water to give us plus phosphine. Okay? Now over here with PH3, there are small amounts of hydrogen and phosphorus dihydride which are also formed. So, iske saath hydrogen and P2H4, these are also formed. P2H4 which is formed, that is removed by two methods. The first method to remove P2H4 is by passing the evolved gas. Through a freezing mixture which condenses P2H4. Which is going to condense P2H4, right? So जो यहाँ से गैस निकलेगी, उसको हम लोग freezing mixture के through pass करते हैं, तो P2H4 जो है वो condense हो जाता है, right? Or we can also do it by passing the gas through HI. So we have PH3 plus HI. This is going to give us a compound PH4I, और ये जो PH4I है, इसको फिर हम KOH के साथ react करते हैं to give us pure form of PH3. Okay, so we're getting a pure form of PH3 by passing it through KOH. Physical properties करें phosphine की अगर when we are looking at the physical properties of phosphine, it is a colorless gas with garlic odor. It has a garlic smell. Okay? Otherwise, it is a colorless gas. Or it may sometimes also has a rotten fish smell. It may also have a rotten fish smell. Okay? Then number two, it is heavier than air. It is heavier than air and it is poisonous in nature. It is heavier than air and it is poisonous in nature. Let's go on to the chemical properties. So when we're looking at the chemical properties of phosphine, the first chemical property of phosphine is that when heated to approximately 440 degrees Celsius, it gets converted to phosphorus. 440 degrees Celsius, it gets converted to phosphorus. Okay, and secondly, it is highly combustible. So, agar isko hum react karte hain with oxygen, if this is burnt in oxygen, it gives us P2O5 plus 3H2O. This reaction is the base for making Gould's signals. Now, what are these Gould's signals over here? These are signals which are given to the ships for any kind of danger which is present under the sea. Koi rocks hai ya kuch bhi hai under the sea, uske liye hum ise use karte. Now, what we do in this is ki we take a mixture of calcium carbide and calcium phosphide. So we are taking a mixture of calcium carbide and calcium phosphide and they are kept in metallic containers. They are going to be kept in metallic containers. And these metallic containers, in that there are two holes which have been formed. Okay. Now what will happen? As the container that is thrown in the sea, what is going to happen? Water is going to pour in through these holes which are present in the containers. So water jab uske andar chala jata hai, then it produces acetylene or phosphine respectively. Kyunki humne calcium carbide or calcium phosphide dala hai, jaise hi ye dono ke dono react hote hai water ke saath, they are going to give us two compounds. One is acetylene. This is acetylene which is formed, and the other one, that is phosphine. Okay, so ye jo dono compounds yahan pe bane, ye dono ke dono compounds, they exist as a gaseous mixture, and the gaseous mixture that is going to catch fire. Because it is catching fire due to presence of P2H4 which is present, so it gives a signal in the air, thereby telling that maybe there is certain, you can say, danger which is present under the sea. Okay, so that is known as Ohm's signals. Okay, then what is the next property of this is, it has a basic nature. We already know that pH3, it has a lone pair of electrons. So pH3 ke paas ek lone pair of electrons present hai. Although it is neutral to litmus, but still it behaves as a weak base. Agar aap litmus ke saath iska test karoge, to humko basic character ka test nahi aata hai. But still it behaves as a base as it reacts with acids to give us compounds like pH4Cl, and if it is reacting with HBr, it is going to give us pH4Br. So it behaves as a very, very weak base. When we go on to the structure of phosphine, structure like ammonia with sp3 hybridization. The hybridization present, that is sp3. So we have with one lone pair of electrons which are present on phosphine. Uses iske kya hai? One use we've just seen that it is used for making Ohm signals. Okay? This is one use, and the second use is, we have just also done this, it is used to make smoke screens. In both the cases, the process or the reaction which is used is almost same, right? And third, it helps us to make metallic phosphites. It helps us to make metallic phosphites. Okay? So this is phosphine. Then next we go on to oxides of phosphorus. Oxides of phosphorus may serve structures in your syllabus. So oxides of phosphorus may, we have P4O6. Right? Now over here, जो phosphorus का structure होता है, sorry, जो P4O6 का structure होता है, it has a basic structure of alternate bonding of phosphorus and oxygen which is going to be present, ठीक है? And each of the phosphorus that is bonded to three oxygens. So if you're looking at this phosphorus over here, it has 1, 2 and 3 oxygens. Similarly, if you're looking at this phosphorus over here, it has 1, 2 and 3 oxygens. Right? So each of the phosphorus, it has 3 oxygens and there is a lone pair of electrons which is present on each phosphorus. Right? So we are saying that each phosphorus is covalently bonded to 3 oxygens. It is going to have 12 sigma bonds. This is one competitive ka question. 12 sigma bonds and 16 lone pair of electrons. Okay? It is going to have 16 lone pair of electrons. Clear ho gaya? Then the second structure which we have, that is of P4O10. Phosphorus pentoxide. This is phosphorus trioxide, that is phosphorus pentoxide, P4O10. In this also the basic structure that is going to be same. This is the basic structure of phosphorus. Ab yaha pe again you have this, then each of the phosphorus is doubly bonded to oxygen. In certain books, it is also given a coordinate bond instead of a double bond. Okay. Now over here, it has 16 sigma bonds. This is the type of question which you can get. And it has 4 pi bonds. 16 sigma bonds and 4 pi bonds, right? And it is going to have 24 lone pairs of electrons. 24 lone pairs of electrons with 1, 2, 3, 4 is the rase. Oxygen ke lone pairs, now they have been considered over here. So it is going to have 24 lone pair of electrons. ठीक है, so ये आपका phosphorus P4O10 और यही आपके syllabus में है सिर्फ दोनों के structures और questions आपको इस वाले में से आ सकता है कि P4O6 में कितने sigma bonds हैं और कितने pi bonds हैं, so it has only sigma bonds which are 12 और P4O10 में 16 sigma bonds and 4 pi bonds, okay? Then the next topic which we have, that is oxa acids of phosphorus. oxa acids, it forms the following oxa acids. The first one, that is hypophosphorus acid. Hypophosphorus acid, it is also known as phosphinic acid. नाम आपको इसके पता होने चाहिए, फॉस्फीनिक एसिड. इट हैज द फॉर्मूला H3PO2 एंड इट हैज द स्ट्रक्चर present as hydroxyl group, therefore only this hydrogen will be replaced. ठीक है, so जो basicity depend करती है acids की, वो किसके ऊपर depend करती है? Number of hydrogens which can be replaced. So over here only one hydrogen can be replaced, therefore the basicity of this acid, that is going to be equal to 1. This helps you to find the equivalent weight. ठीक है, तो आपने याद रखना है कि इक्विवेलेंट वेट जो है वो इसी से आप फाइंड कर सकते हो. बेसिसिटी ऑफ दिस दैट इज इक्वल टू 1. सेकंड एसिड व्हिच वी हैव दैट इज नोन एज फास्फोरस एसिड, राइट? इट इज आल्सो नोन एज फास्फोनिक एसिड. और इट इज आल्सो नोन एज ऑर्थो Phosphorus acid. This has the formula H3PO3. Okay, and when we're looking at the structure, then this is going to be the structure. As two hydroxyl groups are present over here, therefore basicity that will become equal to 2. Right? Then the next we have is orthophosphoric acid. The next one, that is orthophosphoric acid. जो orthophosphoric acid होता है, it has the formula H3PO4. And the structure which it is going to have is अब यहां पे हमारे पास तीन OH प्रेजेंट है, therefore the basicity of this that is going to be equal to 3. ठीक है, फिर नेक्स्ट जो एसिड है that is pyro phosphoric acid. Pyro phosphoric acid, it has the formula H4P2O7. Please remember the formula and the names H4P2O7. This is going to have the structure. There's a bridging oxygen present in this, and then there are so we have four hydroxyl groups are present, therefore the basicity of this that is going to be equal to 4. So these are the oxa acids of phosphorus. ठीक है, समझ में आ गया? Then lastly we come to halides of phosphorus. When we talk of halides of phosphorus, phosphorus forms two kind of halides. One is trihalides of PX3 type and the other one, that is pentahalides of PX5 type. In this case, PX3 that is going to be more stable than PX5. Okay? Let's take the example over here. We have PCl3 and we have PCl5. इसके भी structures बहुत important है. So PCl3 when we are talking of PCl3, it moist in air. It is going to give us HCl. So it gives us fumes of HCl in air. Right? This is one important reaction. So agar hum log PCl3 ko react karte hain with moist air, right? This is going to give us H3PO3 plus 3HCl. So ye jo dense white fumes nikalte hain, that is due to the formation of HCl over here. Okay, so this is one characteristic properties. Now when we talking of PCl3, it is seen that PCl3 has sp3 hybridization with one lone pair. PCl3 sp3 hybridization, and the angle that is going to be 100.4, and the bond length is 142 picometers. ठीक है, then we come to PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride is not very stable. It is going to dissociate into PCl3 and Cl2. It has a very different structure. The hybridization over here, it is going to be sp3d hybridization. And the geometry is trigonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal. Let's see the structure of phosphorus pentachloride. This is going to be the structure of PCl5. It has two kinds of bonds. One, this is known as the axial bond, and this is going to be known as the equatorial bond. Okay? It has two types of bond, axial bond and equatorial bond. Axial bond is at a 90 degree, so the bond angle in case of axial, that is going to be 90 degree, and the equatorial bond angle, that is going to be 120 degrees. Equatorial bond angle, that is 120 degrees. Okay? It is also seen that the axial bond length hoti hai, that is greater than equatorial bond length. Axial bond length is greater than equatorial bond length. Why? Because in case of axial bond length, there are three bond pair repulsions. What are these three bond pair repulsions over here? This chlorine is going to have a repulsion from this chlorine atom. So this is one, this is two, and the third one is three. The third one is, which is below the plane over here. So it has three bond pair repulsions. Whereas in case of equatorial, there are only two bond pair repulsions. There are going to be only two bond pair repulsions. So if you're looking at this one, the bond pair repulsions which this is going to face is, one is this chlorine and the other one is this chlorine. Okay? That is the reason why axial bond length, it is larger than equatorial bond length. So with this we finish our group 15 today. We will start with group 16 tomorrow. Okay?